Dear ma'am, sorry it's been a while since I last wrote. It took me a bit of time to find my feet, but we pleased today and finally settled now. I hope. It's all going good, ma'am. I'm staying in Kentish Town with these lads I met from Kirby. One of them knows Uncle Robbo's got me some work holding bricks. I mean, it's not my ideal job, but it pays the bills for now. I'll send a bit on to you as soon as I get my first pay packet.
Well, it was very unlike Jimmy to just go and not stay in touch with me. He left me a note when he went, and he wrote, and we didn't have a telephone in those days. And he always sent postcards, and he always wrote.
I hope you got the cash okay. I would have sent more, but I just bought myself a car. I've sent you a photo. It makes me look like a film star. I went to church last week. I got chatting to the priest, Father Greaves. It turned out to be an alright bloke, even if he is a QPR supporter. I watched an NF rally last week from a bedroom window. It was horrible. The stuff they were screaming, and the police weren't even that bothered. You went to see a punk band last night. It's the latest thing, apparently. They were shite. Love always, Jimmy.
And he got a girlfriend. That was the last couple of letters. So, you know, his life was good.
I've moved digs. The landlord needed us out. But I found a good place to stay for now. It's called Arling and Mouse. Everybody's really nice again.
And so when the letters stopped, I just, you know, I had this feeling that it's an awful knot inside, and I thought it's not like him, it's not like my Jimmy, you know, because we're very, very close. We had great times, he was very good to me, and we had great crack about the football and, you know, all of that kind of stuff. But it took a long time before they launched any kind of investigation. It was nearly 18 months, and by that time, sure, nobody knew anything about him, and you know, we weren't important and he wasn't important. And it never occurred to me, you know, that I could do like something like this, like maybe talk to the newspapers or go on the television and ask. And it's nearly 40 years now, and I don't know how to thank DCI Stewart particularly. I'm sorry, now I'm getting emotional and filling up. That's no good to anybody. She took me to where he'd lived when he was in London. And that was marvellous. You know, to see where he'd been, to see where he'd been happy, and to see all the places he talked about in his letters. That was great. It's been really important for me. I know where he is now. I know what happened to him. I have a plot bought up in St. Matthew's, and when I die, I'll go in there with him. And I know that he did love me. That he's at peace now. For parents who don't know where their children are, I hope they find somebody like DCI Stewart who, no matter how long, will go the extra mile, you know, and has such a big heart, and she'll find some peace for them. As far as the loss goes, I don't think there are any words. I don't know how we find our way through it. The loss of a child, and the loss of a child through violence.